Our next guest makes the tiniest insects larger than life, and award-winning UK photographer Matt Doogue says getting up close with them through a camera lens actually saved his life. You see, Matt's mental health was pretty shaky for a while, but his turning point came the day he was given a camera and began capturing a world most of us rarely even think about. And Matt joins us now from Edinburgh in Scotland. Matt, it's good to see you this morning.
Hello. You all right?
Great, actually. But on the weekend, I found myself in lockdown once again, aimlessly, mindlessly scrolling through Twitter, and I came across a tweet that you put out only last week. I'll read it out to everyone. 13 years ago, I tried to kill myself. 12 years ago, I was fired from my job. 11 years ago, I was declared bankrupt. 10 years ago, I picked up a camera. 7 years ago, I was published with National Geographic. 6 years ago, I'd won countless awards. 4 years ago, I got a mortgage. Have faith. Incredible. I had to do a deep dive after reading this, had to find out more about you. Can you tell us a little bit about the mental health struggles you were facing those all those years ago?
Yeah, so I had a breakdown in my early 20s. It was really unexpected and it came quite fast. And it was a result of me sort of living to a rule that I thought I had to live to fit in with society and my peer group. And I became almost a fake person to fit in with these people. And all my passions that I had as a kid, which was nature and biology and geology, they were all shoved away. And there was always something missing from my life. And eventually, you know, these cracks started to show in this mask that I was wearing as anxiety and depression and paranoia. And it all just came to a head where I just lost control of my own reality. I felt like I was a spectator in my own life. And I was just in a real bad place. I wasn't cool to be around. And it resulted in me making an attempt on my life.
Wow. Sarah sent me this tweet as well. It's unbelievable. You're so kind of fascinating, not because of the work that you do, but your insights and things. Where did the camera come from? I mean, what led you to insects and spiders?
So, you know, through my, I won't say discovery of myself, I'll say rediscovery of myself, because that person was always there. It was just hidden away between social conformities and peer pressures from social media. I tapped back into where I was most happiest, where we're most happiest, and we're most happiest as children. We've got no pressures on us. We've got no, you know, no expectations. And when I was a kid, I loved sitting up and watching David Attenborough on TV. I loved being out in the garden with nature and wildlife. So I thought, well, why can I not tap back into that? So I started going for hikes. You know, being out in nature is, nature has this great ability to bring you right into the moment and center you straight away. You know, you can be having a real bad day and thinking all these thoughts, and you could see a bird land in front of you, and you instantly just concentrating on this bird, or concentrating on a butterfly, or a bee, or a spider, and all your worries and stresses disappear. Instead, you're just concentrating in this moment. So whilst I was out doing these hikes, I thought, wouldn't it be cool to take some pictures? So I got a really old secondhand camera, and I delved into the world of photography, and I tried every single genre. But there was always this one genre that kept me coming back, and it was macro photography. And the thing is with macro photography is, I'm when I'm looking at this hidden world, it's a world that none of us really see. It's a world that we rush past every day and we don't really appreciate. You know, these unsung heroes of the world. When I'm looking at them through my lens, I'm almost transported through my camera into their world. And in their world, you know, fake news and pressures of society and social media comparisons and conformity doesn't exist. Nothing like that exists there. It's just you and the subject. And I completely disconnect. And the more I did this, the more I realized I was learning mindfulness. And mindfulness is such a great tool we can all use to benefit our mental health. So, you know, nature and mental health, nature is a great healer.
Your photos are just extraordinary. I cannot believe you only picked up a camera a few years ago, and they're the images that you're capturing, just incredible. Matt, I think part of the reason why your tweet struck such a chord with so many people here in Australia is that a lot of people are in lockdown and they feel stuck and hopeless and can't quite see the light at the end of the tunnel yet. Mm. So as someone who's been through some pretty dark times, and you've said that you still have down days, it's an ongoing healing process, but what would you say to people who are feeling like there's no hope?
Well, the first thing to do is reach out and talk. You know, talk to anybody you can. Do not suffer in silence. You know, I did that for so long, and all it did was compile and make things worse. So if you're in an opportunity where you can reach out and speak to some of their friends or family, please do that. If you don't have that luxury, then there's telephone lines out there. There's companies that are set up, and people will speak to you on the phone, and then they will help you through it. Acceptance is a huge thing. It was a huge thing for me. I had to accept that I knew I had mental health struggles. I knew that I was suffering in certain ways. And the moment I began to accept that is the moment I can take control of that, because I knew what it was. You know, if you question things a lot of the time, you can't have control over it. So once I knew, well, that was the issue, now I can control it. So acceptance is a huge thing. And I always, you know, I always think people can get so hung up with social media, and especially in lockdown, you know, we can be in lockdown and we can be in our houses, and then we can be so depressed about things, and we sit on social media and you might see other people in other countries doing things, going on holiday, having a great time. And what we need to realize is social media is a cherry-picked reality. You only ever see the good stuff. You only ever see the end product. You know, you'll see a picture of a happy family, but you won't see the mum and dad 10 minutes previous screaming to their kids to sit still and pose nicely. You know, you just see this happy family. But us sitting at home, depressed, looking at the phone, we just see this end product, and it'll make you feel down. So try and stay away from social media. Pick up a book. Do some exercises. If you've got a garden, get out in your garden. Relax in, you know, in nature, if you can.
Oh, wow. Matt, I'm
so fascinated.
You know what, though, social media sometimes leads to good things, and your tweet led us to you. Thank you so much for sharing your story. Go and check out Matt's photographs. They are extraordinary. The website is on your screen. Matt, have a great day, and thanks for chatting.
You too. Stay safe.
Thanks, mate. Keep being awesome.